Welcome back to our series, and we are now on day 3, part 4, Knowledge of Jesus. We are shifting this time back to the imitation of Christ. We begin today the first chapter of book 1. This is on the following of Jesus Christ, our model, and it starts with this verse from St. John. He who follows me does not walk in darkness. It is a good reminder for all of us to imitate his life if we wish to be truly enlightened and freed from all blindness of heart. Our Lord does not say, I am the light of the angels, nor of heaven, but the light of the world, that is of mankind who live in darkness. This is what we proclaim in the Canticle of Zechariah when we say, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death. The teachings of Christ is greater than the advice of all the saints put together. Therefore, it is our main task to study the life of our Lord. But what is the teachings of Christ? I would like to propose here something simple, where young and adult can follow so easily. This is by looking at our Lord in the mystery of incarnation and redemption through the mystery of the Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The incarnation is a profound mystery of wonderful union of divine and human nature in the one person of Christ. This great mystery of incarnation is made accessible to us through the joyful mysteries, for in it we are recalled by the joys of the Annunciation, Visitation, the birth of the Savior, the Presentation, and the finding the temple. Did our Lord teach us something in these mysteries? Obviously, the answer is yes. We see in the manger the virtue of the extreme humility of God and the profound adoration of Our Lady, Saint Joseph, the Shepherd, and the Magi, who came. The Visitation of Mary teaches us to bring the good news of God present among us to others, especially those who are losing their faith and to those who do not know Christ. Who knows, our visitation would become a channel of God's grace to those whom we visit. The finding of the child Jesus in the temple also teaches us that in the church, we can always find God's mercy and love through the sacraments, especially in the Eucharist. Indeed, the incarnation is so profound, but the ways and the teachings of Christ in these mysteries are very evident. Now let us move on to the mystery of the redemption. This mystery is being recalled in the sorrowful mysteries, the different stages of Christ's passion, the agony in the garden, the scourging, the crowning with thorns, the carrying of the cross, and the crucifixion. What is being revealed here to us in these mysteries is Christ's infinite love for the eternal Father and his infinite love for all of us. We must think of our Lord in these mysteries that we may fill our mind and nourish our soul with his splendor and meaning, that we may pattern our whole life in him, to walk in his light and not in darkness of sin, to live in the life of grace given to us by our Lord himself through the sacraments of the church. If we study the teaching of Christ with his frame of mind and heart, we will find in it the hidden source of consolation and strength. Unfortunately, however, so many people care little or nothing about it, even though they have heard it time and time again, as we read from the Imitation of Christ. By looking at Christ attentively, by imitating his ways and actions, by studying his life, by following his words with love of God and neighbor as our motives, we will be truly enlightened and freed from all blindness of heart. Vanity of vanities, and all is vanities, begins the book of Ecclesiastes. Unless we serve God and love him with our whole heart, when we don't love and serve God, everything becomes meaningless.